Hey, what's up? I'm Davis, and I have never seen a computer before in my entire life until this very moment. So this is episode one of hopefully many of a series I wanted to do, where I am going to be your tour guide through the magical world of art history. I'll be like Rick Steves, except a lot prettier and a lot worse at his job. Welcome to Art Davistory. That's the best I could come up with. Today's topic is ancient Rome. By the way, I love gesturing when I'm gonna like edit in text or pictures later because like there's nothing here. You guys seeing this? It's real. When people think about Roman art, they usually think about these big muscular statues of friggin' frick boys who are so bright white that they make me look like I've probably been outside in the last 3 months. But this wasn't the only kind of Roman statue. A lot of Roman statues were so ripped that they could kill you just by looking at you, but that wasn't the only style that they went with. There were a few eras, actually, where the artist would emphasize the age and, like, wrinkles and stuff of the people to make them look all old and wise and stuff. Because, you know, old people are famously really smart. It was a similar, like, motivation to making them look all muscular, is trying to idealize them in some way. But on one side, they wanted them to look physically strong, but on the other side, they wanted them to look mentally strong. Because as Socrates famously said, the brains are the abs of the mind. This philosophy of emphasizing age and wisdom was called verism. So there's a fancy word you could use at parties if you want to look really lame. This style was really big for a long time, but then Caesar himself came along and said, I want to look hot and ready. And then they started making people look way sexier than they actually were. It was a lot like the photoshopped, like, gym and beach photos you see around today. History repeats itself. They went back and forth between these two philosophies for a really long time. They kind of switched around, depending on the insecurities of the current emperor. There's a sort of third style, though, that showed up with this guy named Caracalla. Like, look at him. He looks kind of wrinkly and unidealized, but he also looks like he can and will beat me up. It's kind of an interesting middle ground between hot and old. If you saw this guy at a gas station, he would definitely be buying, like, a whole tube of Skull Mint, Long Cut, and bunch of combos, and he'd probably try to steal a few Slim Jims. Side note here, one time I was at a gas station with my dad, and he called a Slim Jim a Slimothy James, and I've been chasing that high ever since. Anyway, there's also this statue of Constantine that it looks very... Also, side note number two, there was a guy named Balbinus. There's a common and pretty interesting misconception that these statues were always like this bright white color, but that wasn't actually true. They have done like analyses of the surfaces of these things. It turns out they used to have really bright paint on them. The colors got all worn away over time, and then 100 million years later, in the 1760s, the neoclassical era kind of came around, and people at this time were really interested in these old Roman statues, and they were all totally convinced that they were intentionally all white, because as this one guy said, whiteness is beauty, which on one hand isn't true of these sculptures, and on the other hand, by analyzing the remnants of paint that are still on the sculptures, and by analyzing art at the time and other stuff like that, they think that they actually looked like this when they were originally made, which is crazy. But we really aren't totally sure what they looked like because we don't have very much of the paint left. So they might have looked like this, but they might have also looked like this, or like this, or even, and I hope it wasn't this one, but like this. By the way, you guys should screenshot this template I made and draw your own theories of what you think Roman sculptures looked like at the time. DM them to me at TerraAnnalita on Instagram.com. I think that would be fun. Next up, let's talk about the Colosseum. So this famous round building used to be a theater because every Roman was a theater kid. And this one, the most famous one, is actually a deep dish Colosseum. Over in New York, they have thin crust Colosseums, which is neat. So back in the day, they would do plays, reenactments of historical events, parties, all kinds of stuff that would have been so fun to participate in, except for the part where all of these things were nasty. Like in the plays, they would actually kill people, and all of the historical events that they reenacted were wars, and they would reenact killing people by killing people. And basically every single game they played was a game of who could kill each other fastest. Every day was like a guar concert in this thing. Parties were pretty cool though, like the music they played was pretty good, and Habaranius made a killer seven-layer dip. Despite the killing of people and vibes at this place, the Colosseum was a very popular spot. It could hold, and I triple-checked this by counting the seats myself, 50 billion people. So these fancy seats at the bottom were made for the rich and powerful people. They were made out of marble because they were in the splash zone, and marble is easy to clean. Then the middle areas were the people who were rich but less powerful. Then the nosebleed seats up here were reserved for poor people, oof, women, yikes, and slaves, double yikes. And their chairs weren't made of marble, they were made out of stupid poor people wood for losers and poor people. The poor people and slaves and women may have gotten murdered and got to sit in stupid seats and their whole life sucked. Their chairs were really lame. But on the bright side, at least they weren't named Balbinus. Alright, thanks for learning about Rome with me today. If you want to learn about this stuff from people who actually know what they're talking about, go ahead and click some of the videos in the description. I will link some fantastic videos down there that I watched. Tune in next time for some other thing. I don't know what.